Hey guys, welcome back to another week of What's for Dinner. My name is Andrea with Foodimentary Adventures in Food. We are all about the food on our channel. We do taste tests, recipes, grocery hauls, and what's for dinner. And we are kicking off another week. What you'll notice is that this dinner video is coming out on Tuesday instead of Thursday. So we are switching it up a little bit. From here on out, our dinner videos will come out on Tuesdays. So tonight we are having a pantry meal. So we are having some leftover Mexican rice. And I made this the other day and we had some leftovers. I wanted to use it. And I have a really simple recipe for this Mexican rice and I recorded a video on it. So I'll make sure to link it below. Now the difference between this Mexican rice and the one that you'll see on the video is that for this recipe, I use salsa verde, which is a green salsa. On the original restaurant style rice, I used a just regular traditional red salsa. So we're having that. We're also having some refried beans, and this is what we are using. This is what I had in my pantry. And these were new to us. These are instant refried beans, jalapeno flavor. So all you do is boil some water and then you add these in. And it's kind of like making instant mashed potatoes. However, what was kind of surprising to me is that when you open up the package, these don't exactly look like beans, dried beans. They look a little bit different, but they turn out like that. So we tasted them and Howard thinks they're pretty good. I think they taste a little bit more dry than a regular, you know, than regular refried beans that you would buy in a can, but he seemed to think they were okay. So we're having refried beans and then we're having enchilada casserole. And I made this using ingredients that I already have on hand. I had some chicken in my freezer that I cooked up when I found some chicken on sale. I cooked it and I shredded it, so I had that pre-portioned in the freezer. I also had some corn tortillas in the freezer too. And I had cheese, sour cream, and cream of chicken. So I am going to insert a video or a link in right now, and I will show you how I made this. Hey guys, so this is enchilada casserole. This is a really quick and easy recipe that I made up using stuff that I have in my freezer and in my pantry and my fridge. So let me show you what you're going to need. You're going to need 16 ounces of sour cream. You're also going to need a can of cream of chicken. You're going to need 4 ounces of the green chilies. And then you're going to need some tortillas. Now the tortillas I had in my freezer, this is a pack of 30. These are the small corn tortillas. And we only used about half of them before I stuck them back in the freezer, excuse me. So there's about 15 tortillas in here. And then whenever I find chicken on sale, I always cook it up and then I shred it and freeze it. So this is about probably 3 cups of shredded cooked chicken breast. And then I have about probably 4 cups of cheddar cheese. And in this bowl, I have already mixed the sour cream, the cream of chicken, and the green chilies. And I have my stove preheating to, or my oven, I should say, preheating to 350. So I'm going to quickly show you how I layer everything up. Okay, so I have an 11x7 pan, and the first thing you're gonna do is to put a little bit of the cream cheese mixture on the bottom of your pan. And you're just gonna spread it around a little bit. And then you're going to start layering your tortillas. So I'm going to use 4 tortillas per layer. So I'm just gonna lay it out just like this. And that is my oven saying that it is ready. So I'm gonna spread a little bit more cream cheese. I'm sorry, sour cream mixture over this. It doesn't have to be perfect because it's a casserole and everything's gonna blend together once you put it in the oven. So another layer of the sour cream, and then I'm just gonna use some of my chicken, spread that out, some of my cheese, and then you're going to repeat the layers. Okay, so here it is. I've layered everything up. My oven is already ready to go, set at 350. So I'm gonna stick this in the oven for about 30 minutes or so, or until all the cheese is melted. Hey guys, so for dinner tonight, we did not feel like having leftovers, and neither one of us was really hungry, so Howard is having these Shanghai seafood dumplings. He is having the Alaska cod dumplings, and here they are, they're microwave. Now, I haven't tried them because I'm not big on fish, but he said they do taste like fish. He said they're pretty good, but they're not soup dumplings, so they don't have the liquid in the middle of them, but he is having them, or these, I should say. And I am just having a bowl of ramen soup, and this is what it looks like. And I've never had this before, and I've had it in my pantry for a while. I really don't remember where I got it from, but I tasted a little bit of the broth, and it's very good. It's really flavorful. So anyway, this is what we're having for dinner tonight, and we'll see you next time. Hey guys, so for dinner tonight, we are having sesame chicken. And here is what the package looks like. It is from Innovation. And I usually like their food, but I've never had the sesame chicken. And it is a lightly battered tempura chicken breast with a sweet and savory sesame sauce. And this is what it looks like on the package. And here is what it looks like on the plate. And I am serving it over some jasmine rice. And the package directions for the sesame chicken say that you can bake the chicken or pan fry. And I chose to pan fry the chicken. And then we are also having a pork egg roll. And this is what the package looks like for this. I showed this recently on a Tom Thumb haul. And we really like these egg rolls. I'll show you another picture. They're really good. I cook them in the air fryer, and you get four in a package. And they have pork in them and cabbage, and they're really good. And they also come with little sweet and sour sauce packets. And I don't eat the sweet and sour sauce, but Howard does. He really likes it a lot. So this is what we are having for dinner tonight, and we'll see you guys next time. Hey guys, so for dinner tonight, I stopped by the kolache factory earlier today and brought these home. And here's what it looks like. There is some controversy about how you pronounce kolache. So I say kolache, other people say kolak, I don't know. But basically what it is a kind of yeasty bread, and it's stuffed with either meat or sweet stuff. And so it's served room temperature, and they'll warm it up for you. I think it's like in a microwave, or my preference is to bring it home and warm it up in the oven. So Howard's first one is a creamy spinach. And then here are the other three that we had to cut open to figure out what they are. So he got a brisket one, barbecue brisket, and then he got a chicken enchilada, and he got a, I think it's an Italian chicken. And then for me, I got a bacon and cheese, and then a sausage one. And then for dessert, we got this huge, I cannot remember what it's called, but it's like a twist, kind of like a long cinnamon roll. So we are going to split that, and it's really big. It's at least, gosh, maybe 12 inches long. It's pretty big. Anyway, this is what we are having for dinner tonight. This is one of Howard's favorite, restaurants. So this is what we're having for dinner tonight. We'll see you guys next time. Hey guys, so for dinner tonight, I was craving a salad. I went to Kroger yesterday just to pick up a couple of things for this dinner we were going to, and I noticed that they had some organic butter red lettuce on sale. So what I typically do is I'll get lettuce, and then I'll go to a salad bar and just get all the fixings and all the sides, because to me it's cheaper than if I were to buy, you know, just olives on their own, or onion and all that stuff, broccoli. So in my salad, and it's kind of hard to see, I have some pasta from the pasta salad. Some pasta from the salad bar. And I think it was like an Italian salad. And then I have some olives. I chopped up some broccoli and some red onion. And then also I have some Parmesan cheese in there. I have some crispy wonton strips. And then I also have some grilled chicken in there as well. So it's like a hodgepodge of a salad. And then I still have my favorite shiitake salad dressing that I love. I love this stuff. So that is the salad dressing that I'm using. And Howard is just having butter lettuce with just ranch dressing. He didn't want any toppings on his. So anyway, this is what's for dinner tonight. Salads. See you guys next time.